Hi everybody, I'm Naufal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss regarding group dynamics. Okay, group dynamics. Group dynamics, the word comes from two words, that is group and dynamics. Okay, it comes from two words, that is group and dynamics. So what is mean by group? A group means two or more individuals work together to achieve a common goal. A group means two or more individuals, two or more peoples will be there in a group and they are working together. They are working together to achieve a common goal. A common goal will be there. Two or more peoples will work to achieve that common goal. That is called group. So what is meant by dynamics? Dynamics means, it comes from a Greek word which means study of force. It is a Greek word. Dynamics is a Greek word which comes from Greek word which means study of force. Okay, study of force. Got it? So group dynamics refers to a force operating wide in the group for social interaction and interest. Okay, a force is operating widely in the group for what? For social interaction and interest. Okay, let's see the definition of group dynamics. Group dynamics is defined as, it is a social process from which the people interact face to face in small groups. Okay, it is a social process by which the people interact face to face in small groups. Okay, so group dynamics is a social process, it's a part of the society in which the people will interact face to face. The peoples are interacting face to face in small groups. Okay, so it is a social process in which the people will interact each other face to face in small groups. That is the simple definition of group dynamics. Next we can see the types of group dynamics. It is mainly classified into two, that is the formal work or task force group and the informal or social group. The formal work group, okay, first one, the formal work group or task force group, which means it is established by the organization. An organization is establishing a formal group for what? To achieve the common goal or common task of the organization. There will be some task or some goal will be there in an organization. To achieve that goal, the organization is creating the formal group. For example, nursing department. Okay, in nursing department, in the hospital, there is a group that is nursing department. For what purpose? To provide quality of nursing care. The organization is making a formal group, that is nursing department. The main goal is to achieve the common task or goal, that is to provide quality of nursing care. So for the purpose of the organization to achieve the common goal, formal group or task force group is created. Okay, next classification is the informal or social group. The informal or social group, that means to increase the friendship, to reinforce the friendship and to promote the socialization and to reduce the stress related to the job, the informal group is created. Okay, the informal group or the social group is created to reduce the stress related to the job and for the friendship, to increase the friendship and to increase the socialization, informal group is created. For example, clubs. Okay, you know there are so many arts club and there are so many sports club. The main aim is to increase the friendship, okay, as well as to increase socialization and to reduce the stress related to the job. Okay, these are the two classification of group dynamics. Next we can see the phases of group dynamics. It is mainly classified into, we can see four phases of group dynamics. First one is dependent phase. Okay, dependent phase is the first phase of group dynamics. The first step of group formation is dependent phase. While making a group, the first step is dependent phase. In the dependent phase, all the members of the group will be anxious and they will feel a insecurity. They will be anxious and they will feel a insecurity. They need support each other. Okay, you can call dependent phase as a forming phase. Okay, you are forming a group. That time the members will be anxious and they will feel insecurity. They need each other support. Okay, that is the first phase. The second phase is independent phase. Independent phase. During independent phase, the members will know regarding the rules of the organization and role of their role in the organization. Role of the organization as well as their role in the organization, they will come to know in the independent phase. Okay, and they will start to feel a group connection. In the second phase, they will start to feel a group connection. Okay, they are a part of that group. They start to feel a group connection and they know regarding the rules and regulation of the organization and what is their role in that organization. That is independent phase. Next phase is interdependent phase. Interdependent phase is the third phase of group dynamics. In that, you can call it as a performing phase. You are performing your duties. Okay, in the third phase. So, interdependent phase, each members have a strong identity. Each members have very strong identity, which means, suppose in a hospital or in the college, this person is the principal or this person is the head of the department, this person is the supervisor. So, each members will have a strong identity in the third phase. Okay, and they will trust each other. They will trust each other in the third phase, as well as every person is responsible to their task. Every person is responsible to their task. Okay, that is the third phase, and they are performing their duties. Okay, they are performing their role according to the rule. Got it? Last phase is termination phase. Termination phase is the last phase of group dynamics. In that, every work is completed. All the works are completed. Now, the group members are ready to leave the group. That is termination. Okay, work is completed and the group members are ready to leave the group. That is termination phase. That's all regarding the phases of group dynamics. Next, we can see the purpose of the group dynamics. Okay, purpose of the group dynamics. So, the group dynamics will help to achieve the goal of the organization. The group dynamics will help to achieve the goal of the organization. That is the first purpose. Okay, so a group feeling will help to achieve the goal of the organization. Next one is to reduce the stress and anxiety, group dynamics is required. Okay, to reduce the stress and anxiety related to the job or related to the organization, a group dynamic is required. Okay, next one is to develop the leadership quality, group dynamic is required. The next purpose is to develop the leadership quality, group dynamic is required. Okay, next one is to develop and to train the new member of the group, group dynamic is required. To develop the quality of the new member as well as to give training to the new member, group dynamic is required. Next one is to utilize the ideas of the group members. The different members will have different ideas. To utilize that ideas, group dynamic is required. This all regarding the purpose of the group dynamics. Okay, I hope you have understood the topic. We'll meet soon with another video. Till that, thank you and goodbye.